enjoying the weather. Spring, I think, has finally arrived. And while it's spring, most people are spring cleaning their homes, but not necessarily cleaning out their most important home, which is, of course, the body. Well, today we have an award-winning author, a health and nutrition expert, who is going to give us some healthy eating tips that will help cleanse the body. And without further ado, please welcome friend to the show, Nancy Addison. Hello and welcome, Nancy.
Thank you. It's always great to be here.
Oh, we love having you. We love that you always stop in here in the Bronx when you're in town, hailing all the way from Texas. Doing wonderful stuff, transforming our society, transforming our bodies, and what a better way to kick off the spring.
Yes, absolutely. After being locked in for the winter with a lot of toxins being circulated in the air, we want to detox and really let go of a lot of these things that get into our body from breathing it in or from water or from different types of food. So we're going to talk about cleaning out our cells today so that we can really add the really healthy things back in and just have a healthier immune system.
Okay, and let's talk about, while we're discussing what these items are and how to do so, let's talk about the importance of doing that, right? Because I think it's important that people understand that the body transitions with the seasons as well, right?
Absolutely, yes.
And so being in the dark, or for lack of a better word here, you know, because the truth is like there's very little sunshine, which obviously minimizes our vitamin D intake. And you're the expert. I'm going to let you take it over. But I just want everyone to understand that it's really important for us to make the time to just care for ourselves in places that aren't necessarily visible.
Yes.
Which is inside.
Absolutely. And you are just right on it. Rhina, always. The sunshine is critically important. In fact, there's a new study that showed that 77% of cancers could be prevented if people would just go outside and get more sunshine. In fact, my little cup I use here for what I'm going to talk about first says, go outside, y'all.
Yeah, that's what it says. Of course, it's got to have that draw, that southern draw. It's like, go outside, y'all. I like,
right.
Cool.
So, to start with, one of the basic things people can do first thing in the morning is before you even brush your teeth, right when you get up, we can do what we call oil pulling. And a lot of toxins get into our mouth in the middle of the night. And if we put some coconut oil, and I'm talking real pure coconut oil, nothing that's been fractionated, nothing that's been trans fatted. So you want to get one, they're usually white, but pure coconut oil. Just put a teaspoon of it in your mouth, and then you just swish it around for about 15 minutes. And I know that may sound really strange, but the lauric acid in coconut oil really supports your immune system, and it's antibacterial, antiviral. And so it absorbs a lot of the toxins, and then you spit it out after 15 minutes, and then you use a tongue scraper. And these are only a couple of dollars at the pharmacy. And you just scrape off your tongue and get it really clean. And this will make your mouth feel so fresh during the day.
You know, I don't think we pay attention to our tongue well enough. I know I don't. And I didn't even realize that they had these. So this is a tongue scraper that is going to remove everything that's just been...
You just scrape your tongue.
Uh-huh.
And it is amazing. I usually do it two or three times, and I'll rinse it off between scrapes. And then after you've done your oil pulling, this is really important. You want to get a clean, non-chlorinated, non-fluoridated water. And you can get something as easy as a zero water filter at Target or Bed Bath & Beyond for about $40. But you want to avoid plastics in your water. So you want to avoid the plastic water bottles because those have high synthetic estrogen. So that's something we want to detox from. So you put some water in a cup, and then you want to have salt with that. And I know salt's a really confusing thing for most people. They think, well, I shouldn't have salt. But really, salt is necessary for our health and well-being. In fact, we can't hydrate effectively without salt.
And so I just want to share with everyone the type of salt this is, which is Himalayan salt. And if you could just enlighten us a little bit about because I understand this particular salt comes with special benefits.
Oh, absolutely. In fact, there's some other varieties as well, the Bolivian rose salt, and also there's a brand out of Utah called Real. And these are old oceans. These are old mined oceans that were before pollution, when there was many more minerals and things in the oceans at that time. So the salt from the oceans today usually has mercury in it. So you can get that mercury, and we're going to detox from that. But you want to get an old mine salt, and it should have color, because minerals have color. And if your salt is white, it could have been bleached. It'd still be called sea salt, but you don't ever want to get white salt. You want salt with color. And the word electrolyte is simply a fancy medical term for the word salt. So that helps you hydrate. So you put some warm salt water in your mouth, and you gargle with it after you do your oil pulling.
So I want to make sure they understand. You're putting this inside of the water, preferably not a plastic cup, and you rinse, right? That's what she just said. I just want to make sure.
That's right. You gargle, and then you drink a big glass of it. And so when we wake up in the morning, we're really empty, and what we want to hydrate first thing. And as you detox, one of the most important things is drinking a lot of good quality water to help flush the toxins out. So I like to use coconut water as one of those, because it's full of electrolytes, and it's incredibly good for us.
So when you see the coconut water, okay, so first you rinse with this, and then you say you take a big gulp of the salt in the water. Yeah. Are you suggesting that you use coconut water to actually drink it?
So coconut water is just something that's an alternative to regular water. A lot of people get tired of plain water, but coconut water was actually used for blood transfusions in World War II when they couldn't get blood. It's very close to our own blood physiology, so it's like very, very good for us.
Yeah, that's in your book too.
And it's very refreshing. And so it's just an alternative to plain water. But the water first thing in the morning is incredibly important. And then with breakfast, I would definitely add some green powders to your breakfast, or just have it mixed with a little water. But there's an indoor organic garden of Poughkeepsie that's making a new broccoli powder that's raw and nutrient-dense, full of wonderful nutrients like sulfur, which helps carry oxygen into our cells. And sulfur and vitamin C and some of these nutrients are incredibly fragile and get destroyed easily. And so when we add that to our diet, it goes into our cells, it flushes out the toxins, and it really helps detoxify us from a lot of different things. And then it also adds those nutrients to your body that you need in order to be healthy.
So this is certified organic vegetable powder.
And if you order it and tell them Nancy sent you, they'll give you a discount.
All right, now. There's only one Nancy in town.
And the spirulina is a blue-green algae powder, and you can also use chlorella. But those are wonderful at detoxification. And so help detox you of these poisonous things that can hurt our body, like synthetic, artificial, the things from chemical fertilizers or pesticides. People don't realize that a lot of the light bulbs today emit a mercury vapor, so you're breathing that in. One of the things you can do to help detox from the mercury is glutathione. It's a nutrient that is really great at detoxification of mercury, but also vitamin C, which is prevalent
where do
in a
they
lot
sell
of
this?
Fresh fruits. So
glutathione.
Some of these you can find at health food stores, or I have to admit I order a lot of things online. And if any of y'all have a question, you can always email me on my website, and I'll be happy to let you know that. But you know, in the back of my books, I have a lot of resources, and so I, you know, other than the recipes, I include how to find some of the things I
know.
Talk about.
I love it. This is my go-to book, the how to be a healthy vegetarian. Even though I'm semi-vegetarian, there's a lot of health tips in there. A lot, lots and lots of them.
And then it's almost spring, so a lot of the farmers have greenhouses, so they're bringing fresh fruit and vegetables to the markets, even in the wintertime sometimes. But local fresh food is going to have more nutrient density to it. And you want to eat organic, non-GMO. And the reason is because it's going to have more nutrients in it. And when they use synthetic fertilizers and pesticides on your food, it destroys those fragile nutrients that are so essential for our overall health, and detoxification. So vitamin C, sulfur, chromium, things that are absolutely critical for us being having a healthy immune system and a healthy thyroid. And so you want to have a lot of fresh fruits and vegetables. Citrus is really great. And the antioxidants are the color. So look for fun things like purple potatoes and bright oranges. And a lot of you might be juicing. If you're juicing, add the skin. The skin has more nutrients in it than the fruit itself. And if you're doing fruits, always eat the whole fruit because the fiber is so important. And that is a really important part of detoxification because the fiber in the food is going to absorb the toxins in your body and then help get them out of your body.
And help the digestive system. Absolutely. Thank you so much. We love when you're here. Oh my gosh. It's like you're a walking encyclopedia. I say it all the time. So before we go, I did want to share this wonderful news. Your books are now available in audio form.
Yes, I'm very excited. I finally got them on audio. And I know so many people like to listen to books today because it's easier when you're driving or riding in the subway. And so it makes it a lot easier. And so I'm very thrilled. Thank you.
Wonderful. Thank you. Thank you, Nancy, for always coming and sharing your knowledge with our viewers. You guys, it's so important to take care of yourself. So for more healthy cleansing tips, be sure to visit organichealthylifestyle.com. And also, Nancy Addison's books are now available in audio form, as we just mentioned, and you can check that out on platforms such as Amazon. All right. So